What do you think would happen to the world if every human on Earth vanished for 24 hours? Would it be pleasant, or would it be even worse than it already is? What would happen to the plants and animals in such a scenario? Can everything manage to go on if there are no humans around? Well, here's what's likely to happen. Planes falling to the ground, one by one, wherever you look. There will be damaged cars on the highways, some of which are destroyed by fire, while others have pulled over to the side of the road in a mess or have fallen into a swamp. The railways are also in shambles, completely unsuitable for transport. Hundreds of thousands of trains have crashed all over the world, and it doesn't stop there. There are overturned cars and tanks containing thousands of tons of grain, coal, and oil, all of which have been spilled on the ground and are far from reaching their destinations. And what about the ocean? Hundreds of ships have been sunk due to collisions with icebergs and rocks. Due to the wrecked transport of goods, hundreds of tons of petroleum compounds have leaked into the water, threatening the innocent lives of sea species. Yes, this is something we should probably not ignore. The concept of humanity vanishing isn't entirely new to us. Indeed, there are numerous videos on the internet about humanity's disappearance from our planet. There are even documentaries that describe what would happen if humans vanished, but they all depict a world in which people disappear permanently. Today, I will be talking about humans vanishing for only 24 hours, completely unexpectedly. Let's imagine that on a normal day, everyone in the world is doing their own thing. And then all of a sudden, for no reason, they all vanish. What would happen now to the things they should be doing? This is going to be a lot of fun, so I'm not going to keep you waiting. Let's get started. As I previously stated, there would be hundreds of burning cars on the roadways, and this is only the beginning of the terrible fire that may cover the entire globe. All living organisms in close proximity to oil refineries would suffer greatly. We all know that it's the people who oversee all of the production processes, so if they suddenly disappeared and one of the tanks ran out of oil, the pressure in the reactor would rise, perhaps resulting in a possible explosion. The fire created by the explosion would spread to nearby tanks, resulting in thousands of tons of oil and refined goods exploding into the air. Everything would burst and burn for a long time as a result of this. Of course, firemen would be of great assistance if there were humans, but because there is no one around, nobody could respond and put out the fires. Therefore, gas leaks and electrical wiring problems would become even worse, even burning entire cities. Without firefighters, the fire would become worse, moving from object to object, house to house, destroying an entire street and maybe a village. A global power shortage would also occur. Because of the collapse of fossil fuel reserves, most fossil-fueled power facilities would simply stop operating. Power failures would start to spread, and as a result, places powered by hydroelectric power stations would be the only places on the planet with a light. As a result, Las Vegas, which receives electric power from the Hoover Dam, will shine brightly like a guiding star in space. All chemical facilities in the world would face problems due to power shortage. This is due to the fact that for gases to remain liquid inside the facility, it requires a low temperature. However, due to the power shortage, the gas storage tanks will heat up, since there's nothing to decrease the temperature. Hence, the overpressure relief valves will open, and tons of different gases are emitted into the environment. And this is just a small-scale disaster. What's bigger than this is that the suffocation would kill many creatures, as well as many plants in the world would be in danger. Moreover, the gases released by the natural gas plants may also be the cause of major impacts, since there would be no one to stop the plants from releasing gases into the environment. The release would spread throughout the surroundings, eventually reaching abandoned cars and gas stations. All it would need is a single spark for a massive explosion to occur. A massive volume of hazardous materials would be spilled into the atmosphere. However, there is some good news. Nuclear power plants would continue to operate under security mode. In this case, nuclear power plants might run for up to 10 days. However, once the liquid in the nuclear reactor cooling systems has evaporated, there will be a global disaster. The consequences of the disaster would be similar to those of the Fukushima Daiichi and Chernobyl nuclear power plant disasters, in which over 300,000 people were evacuated and radionuclides were found all over the world for years. The pumps that deliver water below the ground would quickly stop, so the water would instead flood subway tunnels. Additionally, the impact of people's disappearance on the operation of hydraulic structures would be even more significant. Without humans, there would be no one to keep an eye on the equipment. A few hours of idle time would be enough to cause irreversible damage, such as dam collapsing. If the scenario becomes worse, there would be no one to stop the rapid water flow. This means that vast areas of land would be submerged in water, leading to the complete destruction of woods, fields, and animals. Although the production lines and plants and factories would continue to run without people, however, there would still be problems. Since there was no one to manage the process, conveyor lines would be stacked with commodities and merchandise. Many processes would run for an entire day until the equipment overheated or the system failed. The problem of products being stacked in conveyor lines may stop when the electricity goes out, but the issues would not stop there. Businesses that lost electrical power would incur significant losses as well. Small farms and stores that have no electric generators of their own won't be able to keep their refrigerators at the proper temperatures, affecting the livelihood of the farmers in charge. Aside from these, the air would be thick with smoke as a result of the fires from the burning cars and cities, both industrial and residential complexes. It's worth mentioning that, except for the occasional forest fires, the suburbs would be relatively quiet. Deforestation would stop for a while because there would be no humans to do it in the first place. Certainly, there would be many fish and other marine animals that would be preserved due to humans' 24-hour disappearance. However, 24 hours is insufficient to make a real change to the Earth's vegetation and wildlife on a worldwide scale. We are all aware that humans have already released so many greenhouse gases into the atmosphere that one day, or even a month without them, would not be enough to restore the planet's balance. On the other hand, any pets or wild creatures that remained without humans would absolutely enjoy the beautiful night sky, as long as nothing was burning or smoking nearby them. Additionally, the entire Milky Way would be visible in the night sky, since light pollution would be less and there would be most likely good weather conditions. When it comes to space, there would be no one to oversee the International Space Station's operations from Earth, such as altering its orbit to keep it at the right altitude to avoid colliding with space debris. And who knows if it collided with an asteroid or satellite, or perhaps fell to the Earth during the day when there were no humans around. In other cases, the world's most powerful observatories may miss a once-in-a-lifetime event in space. In 24 hours, anything might happen in space. Perhaps the ninth planet will be discovered on that precise day. Maybe Voyager 2 has important news to share with Earth. A single day is all it takes to miss a significant scientific breakthrough. I share this information with you, not for the sake of imagining what it would look like when civilization comes to an end. However, I understand how much we impact the planet due to this content. We've existed on this planet for less than 300,000 years. If we compare it to the length of the time the Earth has been around, which is about 4.5 billion years already, that number is absolutely nothing. This means that if we are to squeeze the entire history of the planet into 12 hours, it would only be the last 2 seconds that humans would appear. Isn't that kind of short? But unfortunately, humans are able to disrupt the forces of nature for that brief period of time. But if people were gone for 24 hours, there would be no one to manage the processes, drive the cars, or even monitor space. As we have seen, Earth would face tremendous losses while humans are away, in the same way that humans would require years of hard work to recover from the effects of their brief disappearance once they return to Earth. How long do you think it would take for humankind to repair everything that was damaged after their 24-hour disappearance? Leave your thoughts in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.